Hello and welcome, my friend. Here is card doctor Peter Finn, and next I am planning to show you that how to repair this vacuum cleaner's bad hose, and this is very common issue, and how to repair that thing. And there is now situation that how to fix this in wise way. There is now thing that I can still reuse this my old hose, or then I can purchase new spare part hose, and I need to only install that in this area. And in some vacuum cleaners this replace is really easy, and we need to only open these locking clamps, but in some vacuum cleaners we need in that area some glue. Okay, and then when I am starting to open these joints, firstly I need some protective leather gloves, because there is always risk that we can make dents and scratch in our fingers, and that's my friend, always use work gloves, because they protect this our skin, and then we can work longer. And now when I am planning to take out this old and this broken part, this is very easy to take out, so that I look that joint, and there is small dents in here, there is one dent in here, and in another side is similar. And now I need flathead screwdriver, and then when I press that in this direction, inner this area, this small area, in that way, in that way, now it goes deeper, I have to same time pull out that upper joint. And it happens so that I install my tool in here, and then in same time I little bit pull out in this way. The idea is to pull out this joint in here, and then that area is ready, and in that area we have similar, and in also I press this area down in this way, and then I carefully I take this joint away. And now notice that there is this connector to vacuum cleaner, and then this is like gasket, and that gasket we can remove so that this rotation is this let's look that in what way it goes. Now it seems that this is really hard to rotate, and let's take that, is this like, it looks like it is total joint. Okay, sometimes this opens and sometimes not. And now there is a situation that I can't rotate this part away. And then I have to take that away, and for that job I need now sharp knife. And firstly I cut this my hose in little bit far away in this way, and then when I have to take that old hose away, it happens so that I carefully cut this old hose away, and be carefully that you don't hurt yourself, because knife is always very dangerous. And then I install that in carefully in here, and I bend that this away, and be very carefully, because if I do in that way I can cut directly to my hand, and that's keep that hole like free, that I can insert that my knife. And now I am planning to little by little I take that old hose away in that way, good, and very carefully, because this knife is so sharp. Now I have to work really carefully. And now I think that if I carefully, and then I can install that in my table, and all time do not insert your hand in that area, because I have made one time mistake and I insert this my knife directly in here. Can you see the scratch? And this scratch came from this knife. This is so sharp and it goes like half inch, and there is big blood hose in here, and I had to visit in hospital. And that's, I am now more wiser, and I am more carefully that I don't insert anything in your back area. But now I open this back area carefully and work very carefully with that one, because this knife is so dangerous. Now I am keeping that hole in there. Okay. Okay, there is some glue in there. Okay, and be carefully. And now I work in here very carefully, because this is dangerous job. If I do one mistake, like in that way that I insert that in here, I have bad hurt in my finger. And that's, I have to take this. My idea is to take only this old thing away, this old hose. And let's look a little bit closer at that. Okay, and now I am working so that I take that old hose away in here, and I have to be very carefully that I don't do any hurt in my fingers, and always away this knife in my body, because this is dangerous job. And now when I work with this thing like 10 minutes carefully, I take that away, and then we can continue. Okay, and now I planned to take one wooden material in like my back area, and then I can install this my hose in here, and in that area I can more easier to take out this my plastic thing in here, because this wooden plate protects this my hand, because if it goes in here, this knife takes contact in here. And in that way, okay, it starts to open. Okay, and now it opens good. Now I managed to take that old hose away, and this is most difficult part, to take that old hose away in that way. Now this old hose is away in that way. Okay, this is old one, and now I have to connect this my new hose in here in that way, and now I have to do this my hose firstly very accurate, because now there is this small dent, and that's, I have to cut this in like directly and also very carefully in that way. Now I cut this one extra part away. Good. And now I connect this my sealant in here. Good. It looks good. And then I check this inner area that there is no any big holes. Look good. Excellent. And now this hose is ready. Okay. And then I start to use this Sika 221. I have to first open this gap, and then there is this sealant aluminium hole what I have to break, and this breaking happens easily when I have this Phillips head screwdriver and I install this my screwdriver inside here, and then I compress that in. Now we have in leak in there, good, and I have to clean also this my screwdriver next. And then when I am installing this nose, I rotate this part in here, and then I use my knife and I do that little bit bigger, because then I have easier to work with, because then this nose is bigger. Good. And then I need this metallic compression tool, and when I press that switch in here, I can move this piston in here, and then installation in that way, a little bit in that way, and then this part in here, and then I move this switch, this piston in here. And now this my Sika is ready for work, and then I start to compress that, and soon there is coming this glue. Look. Excellent. And there is glue, and then I need my work. And now I am planning to repair this my vacuum cleaner's hose, and I have in here new hose. In here it is like bigger hose, and next I connect these parts together. Okay, and then when I am planning to install this new hose, I need to first protect this area using this Scotch tape, because otherwise that area can be too dirty. And that's I install in here in this area about that side this tape, that this is like that this cleans this area in that way. Ooh. And now when I later take that protective tape away, in that area there is only this glue. And now when I start to install this my parts in here, this is like locking plate what I need when I install this vacuum cleaner's part in here. In that way, good. And in that area, when I am next planning to install that in here, I need to add in this area this glue. Okay, and let's do that next. And I start to press this my switch in here, and then glue gains. And it is good to install in here enough, like in that way, good amount, and all areas in that way, and like 1 inch this area in that way, good. And now it looks like good. and then I release that my switch, and then there is no anymore this glue coming out. And now, because this is Sika 112 best and more grip, the most this best contact to any surface, that I have to use now protective gloves, because otherwise it happens so that this my fingers, they are full of this black glue, and this is really difficult to take out, and that's I use my gloves, and now I install this glue in all areas in same amount, this outer area, in that way looks good, and then I test that how this hose goes now to install inside in here. Looks good, excellent. And then I think that I install this locking plate also in position, because everything looks good. Now I compress these parts like together in that way, also on that side. Good. And now this my glue joint is ready, and final part is to remove this extra glues away, also in that area, in here, and then I need to let this dry about 2 to 4 hours, and then this my connection is ready. Okay, and that kind of information, my friend, and then I remove this cut tape, and now you can see that there is dirties, but this is the idea, and thumbs up, my friend, and see you in next movie.